All right, yo, what's up, peeps? I think it's gonna be the last video I record for today, but it's Tron Walker here again, bringing you another interesting game. Now, starting out, this game is going to be a lot different from the others. What my opponent's playing here is Tron, Eldrazi Tron, to be specific. Think blue Eldrazi Tron, and I am playing Tron Walkers. So let's go ahead and see how this game turns out. Probably gonna be one of the shorter videos I ever make, and you all are about to see why. And this is why right here. The game's over. Right. So in this game, I did get to the point where I would win because my opponent could not really do anything. Oof, man, it's been a long day. I think I was streaming on Twitch for a total of like 8 hours today playing Magic. But yeah, back to this game. If you look at it here in the chat, in the game log, it actually says that things have been happening throughout the game. But then it just stopped at some point. Now, if you go ahead and look down here at the bottom, I pretty much went through and I did my Nicol Bolas Dragon God combo, and I wanted to see what would happen if I did it on game number one. If it would just automatically go to a draw, or if it would say that I won the game or something. So it turns out, if I do it on game number one, what happens is the game ultimately starts getting delayed as far as when you hear sounds of cards playing. And it The game like literally just resets itself. After it freezes up for a little bit. So what it does is it freezes up, then literally the game starts replaying itself. Like you see lands being played, you see lands being tapped to cast permanents, everything that was done during the game is done again by the game, I guess because it's trying to process everything. And then once it gets back to where, the game kind of crashed at, it sometimes goes ahead and, does what it's supposed to do. Other times, it just goes ahead and, like, just straight up crashes. And resets the game back to turn number one. And, pretty much starts the game completely over, which is what happened in this case. It started the game completely over, and my opponent went ahead and conceded. Now, the reason for my opponent conceding is he just didn't want me breaking the game again, and he didn't want to get stuck in the loop, so that's why he went ahead and did it. So, super quick game number one, right, peeps? I wish I had the video recorded of that. I think I might, but the quality wasn't the greatest, so I figure just talking about it here is going to be good enough. If you would like to see the combo happen, there are a couple of videos I uploaded about that. But I'm not gonna harp on it too much. Now, let's go ahead and see game number two. Right, so this here is game two. Tron Walkers versus Blue Eldrazi Tron. Nope. And my opponent's going first here. And of course, like you all know, I'm going to keep this hand because the goal is going to be who can get Karn out first and start blowing up lands or exiling permanents. My case went ahead and played Expedition Map on turn 1. He played a power plant on turn number 2, drew out of Nyssa. I went ahead and played a mine, which means now I just need to go fetch a tower, and I think I fetched on my turn. Because I don't feel like I have to wait for my opponents here, because even if they do go ahead and destroy one of my Tron lands, I'm perfectly positioned here to play an Oath of Nyssa. And then if that doesn't work, I will then play Chromatic Star and then another Oath of Nyssa. So, yeah, I was just in a very good position right there to get Tron online. But luckily for me, my opponent did not do anything. I was able to play a tower and go ahead and play a Karngrey Creator. And then when I went ahead and fetched Liquid Metal Coating, my opponent went ahead and conceded the game, because at this point in time, he knew that I would get Liquid Metal Coating, and then at first I would go ahead and deactivate one of his lands. The turn after, what I do is I go ahead and make the land an artifact, and then use Karn's ability to make it into a creature with power and toughness equal to its converted mana cost. But since it's a land for zero, it's a land with zero converted mana cost. When I do make it into a creature, it turns into a 0/0 creature, which means that it results in it dying. But yes, that was game number 2. You know, quick and sweet once again. You know, Tron matchups are typically pretty quick, because turn number 3 and you find out who win or lose most times. In this case, I just had the bigger payoff on turn number 3, so I was able to win this game. But yeah, it was a pretty fun game. Game 1 was interesting, interactive, but sadly for me, Magic Online didn't save it, because I might have went ahead and crashed the game one too many times, so it just started it back over from the very beginning. I wish it hadn't though, because it was a pretty decent game. I was just super happy about the fact that I was the one that came out on top in the end. But I think for me, I'm usually positioned pretty well against Eldrazi Tron, so that being the case, it makes sense why I would win these games so easily. Because the main thing for me is, even if I'm dealt 6 damage per turn after turn 1, I am usually able to win the game. Okay, yeah, it's about to be 3 a.m. here. But yeah, I'm usually able to win the game against Eldrazi Tron pretty easily. And that has never changed, so that's pretty cool. I always look forward to my Eldrazi Tron matchups. When I saw my opponent here playing Tron at first, I was then thinking to myself, oh man, please be playing Eldrazi Tron. Please be playing Eldrazi Tron. And then when I saw he was playing Eldrazi Tron, I actually celebrated. Because I knew I could be a little bit slower and still be able to win the games. But while at the same time, I do have Karns in here, so I can still play the early game. But my deck is usually more mid-range than anything else. Anyways, peeps, and that was Eldrazi Tron versus Tron Walkers. I know not much happened in that game, or not much that you all could see, but I am sure you all could put it together. Especially if you're a Tron player, you completely understand what Blue Eldrazi Tron is playing. And on the flip side, now I have enough videos to where you can understand what Tron Walkers is playing and how Tron Walkers interacts with the competition. So that's the video I wanted to share. Hope you all enjoyed it. I know there wasn't a lot that went on here though, but hopefully y'all enjoyed it, and I will catch you all in the next video.